Senator Glover Teixeira. First question is with Adriano Albuquerque with Combate. Your line is clear.
Glover, boa noite, parabéns aí pela vitória. Aqui é Adriano do Combate. O primeiro round, cara, todo mundo aqui estava muito apreensivo, achando que você precisava levar para o chão, mas a partir do segundo, principalmente, você dominou a luta em cima, em pé. Você mencionou durante as entrevistas que trabalhou muito com boxe, né, com treinadores de boxe. Isso foi a chave para essa vitória, Glover?
É, com certeza, né, cara? Eu tô treinando aí bastante, eu melhorando em tudo. É a primeira vez aí que eu comecei a jogar os chutes rodados aí na linha de cinturas, entendeu? Eu tá ali tudo na cartola ali, cara, mas às vezes é questão de, muitas vezes na luta eu querer com sede de nocaute, e às vezes é difícil até controlar, porque eu sei que eu pego forte, aí eu fico querendo arrancar a cabeça do cara logo, mas eu acho que essa melhora aí tá vindo de acordo com algumas derrotas que tive, né? E melhorando e ajustando alguns treinamentos aí. Com certeza tá dando certo, né?
E você achou, me diz como é que você se sentiu nesse primeiro round, né? Que ele estava acertando na distância. Qual foi a principal dificuldade ali do primeiro round para o segundo? Onde que você ganhou essa luta?
Não, na verdade, no primeiro round, eu não sei, ele me acertou esse golpe aqui no olho aqui, ó. E foi o único golpe assim que eu senti assim, pegou, né, como a gente fala lá em Minas Gerais, na cachola do olho aqui. Eu não consegui ver direito na hora, mas assim, o golpe que tava pegando na cabeça, eu tava saindo com os golpes, que isso é do boxe, né? A gente bloqueia e a gente fala roll with the punch, né? Vai com socos, entendeu? Para não tomar essa pancada forte aí. Então, não estava sentindo os golpes dele. Eu sabia que eu tinha que ajustar a distância, que estava movimentando bem e eu estava. Mas aí eu comecei a chutar a perna dele. Daí a pouco, depois do segundo round ali, ele começou a ficar na minha frente ali, né? Começou a parar mais. Aí eu sabia que nos rounds finais ali eu ia conseguir alguma coisa ali, um nocaute, alguma coisa. E consegui o knockdown ali no terceiro, eu acho, né?
Você achou que o árbitro acertou em deixar a luta continuar? Para a gente, pareceu que no terceiro deveria ter sido nocaute.
É, o árbitro, na verdade, gritou com ele. Movimenta, lutador, movimenta. Aí ele movimentava, assim, entendeu? Ele tentava defender, não tentando levantar, mas ele fazia alguma coisa. Eu acho que depois do quinto ali, no quarto, eu senti que ele já não queria ficar mais ali, entendeu? E no final do quarto round, eu senti bem dentro de mim que eu ia acabar com essa luta no quinto round ali. Eu já sabia que ele não queria estar mais ali, estava muito machucado e já queria logo sair, entendeu?
E para terminar, Glover, você não saiu um vídeo no, na internet aí que mostra você conversando com ele durante a luta, que você teria dito: sinto muito que a gente teve que lutar. Como é que foi esse momento aí?
Não, ele chamou o juiz ali no quarto round, o quinto, não sei, no último, no quarto round ali, ele chamou o juiz entregando negócio para ele assim. Eu achei que ele estava tentando, pedindo para parar, ou não sei o que ele estava falando ali. Eu até meio que fiquei sem entender assim. Aí o juiz chegou perto dele e falou assim: o meu dente, pega o meu dente aqui, segura o meu dente para mim. Aí eu falei assim: desculpa, Anthony, mas é parte do trabalho. E ele falou assim: ei, man, parte do trabalho.
Ok, Glover, muito obrigado aí pelas respostas. Parabéns pela vitória e bola para frente. Vamos aí subir.
Obrigado.
Thanks, guys. I'm done. That was my last question.
Up next, we have Damon Martin with MMA Fighting.
Hey, Glover, congratulations on the win. Obviously, Anthony came out with a very fast start, and then you kind of, weathered the storm and came back. Did you kind of expect that at the start of the fight?
Yeah, I knew Anthony was going to come to finish the fight. He's
You know, Anthony is a tough son of a gun, man. And, you know, he got some power. He got some knockout, and I knew he was going to come and throw. I like this type of fighter. You know, I like the fight for me. And I was expecting that. I knew I have to adjust the situation. My coach was telling me to let go my hand, let go your hands, you know, let go your hands. But, like, I wasn't finding the distance. So I was like, I have to adjust the distance. And, late in the second round, I start hitting more and figured out that he's stopping more in front of me. So that's when I start getting my fight in my way.
You knocked him down in the third. You had him down again bad in the fourth. Were you surprised that he was able to continue at that point, or that the referee didn't stop it? Because there were a couple of moments where it looked like, you know, it could have been stopped.
You know, looking now, everybody saying Anthony was moving every time the referee say, but you know, he's a lionheart, man. And but the referee should maybe stop the fight, you know, thinking about it now. I mean, even though he was moving, but he wasn't doing anything to, you know, he's just getting beat up. And I hate to see a guy like that. You know, he broke his tooth one time over there. He's giving the tooth to the referee. So you know, I just hate to hurt a guy like that, man. Anybody, you know, and I hope he's okay.
Yeah. You've obviously been in wars yourself, and you want to have every opportunity to come back and, you know, allow the referee to give you a chance to come back. But is there a moment in that, you know, as you go in that fifth round and you ended it pretty early, but, you know, you got to think to yourself, like, man, I almost feel bad putting the punishment on this guy because obviously he was wearing it. You knew how bad he was hurt.
Yeah, I mean, you know, man, not feel bad. I mean, it was a time of day when he called the referee and say to the referee, I don't know if you do, but he called the referee and said, "Here, ref, you know, I didn't understand what he was saying, but the ref come and he say, my tooth, hold my tooth or something like that, you know, because maybe you don't want the tooth in the floor or something. I don't know. But like, then I say to him, I say, sorry, Anthony, but it's part of the job, you know, and he say, hey, man, it is part of the job. So, you know, I like Anthony, man. I don't want to see the guys. I hope he'll be okay, you know. He went to the hospital, but I hope he'll be okay, and he will be okay.
Yeah. Last question for me, Glover. Obviously, four big wins in a row. I know Dana mentioned, and maybe you heard, maybe you didn't, he mentioned, you know, the possibility of a fight against a guy like Dominic Reyes, Jan Blachowicz, the other guy out there, whoever doesn't end up fighting John Jones next. Can I imagine that you would be interested in either one of those fights?
Yeah. Hey, anyone, man, you know, I mentioned young Blachowicz, you know, because the style, I like it. He come forward, he punch, you know, is my type of fight. But whoever, man, top division, I love it.
Thank you, Glover. Congratulations again.
Thank you.
Next, we have Jay Anderson with Cageside Press. Your line is unmuted.
Thanks very much, and congratulations, Glover, and thanks very much for taking the time to do this tonight. First, just want to ask, I mean, it seemed like a couple of times you were close to the finish and you started hunting for the submission. Were you specifically looking to submit him because of the comment he made about maybe submitting you leading into the fight?
No, not really. You know, I just want to, I saw submission over there a couple of times and I wanted to go for it, you know, I wanted to get that submission, you know, and I wanted to just you know, take the guy out of there, man. Finish the fight, you know. You know, I hurt my hand, you know. I don't know if you guys can see. It's, like, pretty bad in the third round. And, yeah, I just want to maybe because I couldn't punch so hard with my right hand anymore. So I was looking for submission.
And there was obviously a lot of talk about the stoppage or the lack of a stoppage, how much heart he had. There's also been a lot of criticism of his corner. Realistically, do you think they should have thrown in the towel?
You know, man, it's tough because you guys like Anthony's people, like, maybe the referee should stop it too. We're looking now, you know, at that time, the ref would say, move, fight, move. I'm going to stop, and every time he say he try, he moves, you know, he tried to move, but it's a situation that, like, man, you know, the guys start getting beat up and not really doing anything to attack, you know, and yeah, I think the referee should just, maybe could stop the fight in the fourth round of the day because he wasn't doing much anymore, you know.
The conversation that you had with him tonight, I mean, we were able to hear it on the broadcast. Is that something that's, you know, you've ever had a talk with someone like that before during a fight?
I don't know. I think maybe a couple times, but like with Anthony, you know, I like the guy. We have a good relationship, you know. Every time we see each other, we talk, we have a beer together, you know. It was a point over there that he gave the two to the referee and say, "Hey man, sorry man, part of the job." And one time he was talking about his jiu-jitsu, you know, trying to finish him. He's like, "My jiu-jitsu is not so bad, man." Something like that, you know. And just talk and have fun, you know. And there was something about the jab too, because his coach would say, "Yeah, you hit him 100% of the jab," man. And I say, "No, not 100%, man. Maybe 50, you know."
All right, last one for me. I mean, you said ahead of the fight, you tend to watch Tyson videos, Tyson highlights to get yourself pumped up before your own fights. Did you watch any specific fight ahead of this one?
Every time I watch a Holyfield and Tyson, man. Just because the spirit of Holyfield, you know, the build up of the fight and the spirit of Holyfield. And I did watch the highlights at the way in the bus. When I was in the bus coming to the arena, I watched the Tyson highlights. But the final countdown, you will put Mike Tyson highlights, final countdown, that music, you know.
Is it the first Holyfield fight or the second one?
The first one. I watched the first one because I just like the spirit, you know, of Holyfield. And I always say, like, move your head like Tyson, hit like Tyson, and the spirit of Holyfield.
All right, man, great stuff. Congratulations again on a fantastic performance tonight.
Thank you.
Up next, we have James Lynch.
Hey, Glover, congratulations on the win. Three quick ones for me. First off, 40 years old and still getting big wins like this. What's the key to longevity in your career? Because not a lot of guys your age are putting on performances like you are.
Discipline, man. You know, my gym t-shirt have the pain of discipline is better than the pain of the regret, you know? And discipline, learning, open mind, you know, help from the PI, help from Trifecta. Thank everybody, my coaches, listening. And keep a discipline, man. Right now I'm going home, take a week off, get this thing done, you know, and get back to training.
And when you say discipline, is that, you know, your diet? Is that, you know, maybe not doing as much sparring to sort of, you know, keep your career going a bit longer? Are those things that you've sort of looked at?
No, I spar a lot. I spar a lot, to be honest. In camp, I spar a lot, you know, but like I do a lot of sparring, man. It's my main thing. I was doing too much conditioning back then, you know, and sparring. That's what the problem. But now we do a lot of 5-round sparring, you know. That's why able to keep fighting like then. In the later rounds, but discipline right now, when I go back, I just keep myself in a great condition. I put myself in a conditioning and hit some pads, drilling. Yeah, no sparring until the camp coming, you know, soon they call the fight, you know, 8 weeks before we get back to sparring.
I know you said earlier you'll fight anyone they give you next. Where is Corey Anderson on that list? Just because that was your last loss. I know he's coming off a loss himself, but is that a fight you'd like to get back?
Yeah, man, I don't think anybody, you know, I fight anybody, man. But yeah, Corey Anderson is like, he's back in the list, you know. I kind of want to fight the top three guys right there, you know. I say John Blokovic is like Jan Blokovic, right? I say right the name?
It's difficult.
But that'd be a good fight, man, you know. I like the style, but I fight, you know. I'm not here to choose a fight, man, especially this time right now. I just want to take a week off, 2 weeks off, and relax for a little bit. But anybody.
And last question for me. You're very close to getting another shot at the title. And John Jones, his last two fights have been very close, a split decision. And the last fight, some people felt like Dominic Reyes won that. Do you see some weaknesses in Jones's game now with the fact he's been pushed twice now to the brink?
Yeah, I mean, different... John Jones is, you know, he's a great fighter, man, you know, and but he's different. He's a different fighter than when we fought. You know, I'm a different fighter, and I just want to take another shot at that title, man, for sure. That'll be a dream, you know. That's my dream, you know, and no doubt that I want to fight him again.
Congratulations, and thank you for the time.
Thank you.
We'll take our last question from Victor Hugo with Super Lutas.
Glover, boa noite. Obrigado aí por estar falando com a gente. Parabéns pelo show hoje, o verdadeiro show que você deu. É, primeiramente, queria saber, você já disse que não, né, não escolhe adversário, enfrentaria qualquer um. Eu queria saber como é que você está se sentindo agora, quando você estaria pronto para lutar, que ano passado você lutou 3 vezes. Seria mais um objetivo esse ano, três lutas?
É, um pouco difícil, assim, com essa pandemia e tudo, né? Vamos ver como que vai ser tudo, mas, assim, eu vou checar minha mão agora, que está bem inchada aqui, eu não sei o que aconteceu, tomara que não seja nada grave. E, claro, quem sabe, 3 lutas, né? 2, 3 lutas aí. Não estou aqui para marcar, mas talvez 2, né?
Bacana.
Tirar uma folga agora e cair para dentro dos treinos.
E se você não escolhe adversário, mas se você pudesse, seu adversário pelo cinturão, se fosse o John Jones, teria um sabor especial por uma revanche ali, algo nesse tipo?
Pô, claro, ainda mais para o cinturão, né? É claro, com certeza.
Só para finalizar, não sei se você, provavelmente você acompanha, você é um grande fã do Mike Tyson, ele também já demonstrou ter um carinho por você. Você tem acompanhado esses vídeos dele no treinamento com o Rafael Cordeiro? E qual que foi a sua reação ao ver aquilo? E se você aceitaria algum dia fazer um sparring com ele?
Pô, seria um prazer fazer um sparring com ele, cara. Com certeza. Seria um prazer fazer um sparring com o Mike Tyson. Seria um sonho, né? Já pensou? Acontecer. Se for falar com o Rafael Cordeiro, quem sabe a gente vai lá e faz um sparringzinho com ele lá, né?
Então é isso aí. Muito obrigado, Glover. That was my last one, guys. Thank you.
Obrigado.
Okay, thank you very much, Glover. You're good to go.
All right, thank you, man.